So the first technique that we will consider is Tomasulo's algorithm. It's really one of the first techniques for out-of-order execution, and now it's more than 40 years old. It was used in the old IBM 360 machines, which are now, again, more than 40 years old. What it does is it determines which instructions have inputs ready so that they can go in the next cycle, and which instructions still have to wait for their inputs to be produced. It also includes a form of register renaming, and it is surprisingly similar to what we actually use today as far as out-of-order execution is concerned. So although this is more than 40 years old, it actually is very useful to know how it works because it's kind of like the first approach, so it's simpler than what we use today, but it really well explains what's going on. The differences between Tomasulo's algorithm and what is used today are only that in the olden days when Tomasulo's algorithm was implemented, they did that only for floating point instructions, while today we do it for all instructions. Also, they had relatively few instructions in the window that they're looking at, meaning they only really looked over some small number of instructions into the, you know, future instructions that need to be executed, while today we look at hundreds of instructions past the one we are still executing. In the olden days, exception handling for floating point instructions was not such a big problem because they were only considering really, you know, execution of kind of floating point intensive applications, and you know, those would be programmed and so on, and you would usually run one program at a time. If there is an exception, you could do some drastic measures. Today, processors include explicit support for exception handling that we will see later. So we will first again look at how the Tomasulo's algorithm did it, and then we will consider how today's processors do these additional things.